I would like to reinforce what we learned in class about conversions between grams, moles, and atoms. Anytime you know how many grams you have of an element, you can get to moles by going to the periodic table and looking up the molar mass. The molar mass off the periodic table has units of grams per mole, so it can be used to convert between these two things of that element. Now, if you know the moles of a substance, you can convert that to atoms or vice versa using Avogadro's number. Now, remember, Avogadro's number is 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd, and that's how many atoms are in a mole. So that's the tool that you would use for that. So you will be typically given either grams or moles or atoms and asked to calculate one of the other items on there. This is dimensional analysis. You will try to cancel the unit you don't want and convert to the unit you do want. Excuse me. So let's go through the three examples I had in class and let's make sure that we can use these tools appropriately. Here is the first one. This one gave a lot of students a lot of trouble because they're not seeing what is given until they see this number here. This is just the value off the periodic table. And when we look at fluorine, we see this number. What does this number mean? 19 AMUs is the mass in AMU units, so this is a mass, of one atom. That number, if we were to up the scale to grams instead, would be the mass of one mole of fluorine. So this would be one atom of fluorine, this would be one mole of fluorine. But notice it's the same number. Now there's a couple of different ways to work this problem. If we look back at our previous example over here, or my kind of roadmap, I know that molar mass is in grams per mole, and it gets between moles and grams. And so if I have this molar mass given to me of 19, I gave it to you as atomic mass, but in molar mass it's 19 grams per mole. Another way to look at this is 19 grams per mole. It can be used to convert between grams and moles. So that's a converter. This number that I gave you is a converter. It is not my starting point. So a lot of people started with this number. And instead, you ought to look at this guy. I have one atom of fluorine. So if I start with one atom of fluorine, and I want to get to grams, let's look at our roadmap. If I know atoms, okay, which are given to me, I can go this way using Avogadro's number to get to moles, and then I can go this way using the molar mass to get to grams. It's a two-step process, and let's write out that strategy. I'm going to go from atoms to moles, and then from moles to grams. So let's work that problem. One atom of fluorine. Now this is an exact number. This is exactly one. It's a counting number, but I have one exact atom of fluorine. I don't want atoms. I want, where am I trying to go? I'm trying to go to moles, so I put moles here. Now, if you have a good concept of what a mole is, you know that a mole is a big number, and here is its big number, 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd. That's how many atoms are in one mole. Similar in concept to, if I had one dozen, I'd have 12. It's a word that means a number, and this is the very big number. Now we can go from moles of fluorine on down to our next step here, right? From moles of fluorine, I put it in the denominator so it will cancel, to grams of fluorine, I put it in the numerator, which is where I'm trying to go. The molar mass off the periodic table, which I actually gave in the problem, is 19. It's that many grams in one mole, similar to being 19 AMUs in one atom. That's just two different ways of thinking of that same number. But we want the gram per mole way of thinking about it. My atoms will cancel, my moles will cancel, and I will be left with grams of fluorine. So the answer to that value is, let me find my calculator. Okay, so I take 1 here. I divide by 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd, and I multiply it by 19. Now, on my calculator and most calculators, the way you would do this is you take your 1 and you put that into your calculator, okay? Then you're going to divide by, and to put this into your calculator, you're going to use your E key, or it might be an EE key, or it might be an EXP key. There's different ways of seeing it, okay? A lot of them are EEs. This function means times 10 to the, so it's putting all of that into your calculator. And the next thing you put in is the 23. So you're taking 1 divided by this. Notice I don't have to use parentheses if I use this key. And that's on the bottom, and then we come to this one. So then we have to do times 19. And it's a bunch of zeros, so I don't have to put in the zeros. That's how I put it in my calculator. When I do that, I get 3.16 times 10 to the minus 23 grams. Now let's think about that number. This is a tiny number, okay? I would have to draw a whole bunch of zeros. I'm moving this over 23 spaces. I don't have time for that many zeros, okay? We have, oops, that's a 3. 3.16, a tiny, 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 tiny mass of fluorine. Does that make sense? Yes. A gram is about the mass of a paperclip. An atom is tiny, so tiny we can't see it even with a microscope. It has a mass that's extremely small, so we would expect to get an extremely small number for that value. Now I'm going to show you one other way to do this problem, which is quicker, but it requires you to think of a concept that you might not have thought about. And that is that I gave you a relationship between AMUs in class. I told you that 1 gram is equal to Avogadro's number of AMUs. It takes this many AMUs to equal 1 gram. So if I have 19 AMUs as the mass of one atom, and they want to know the mass of one atom in grams, then I can go from AMUs to grams using 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd. Notice I'm taking 19 on the top and 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd on the bottom, and that will give me the exact same answer because I'm doing the same exact math. So in this case, I am remembering that it takes this many AMUs to equal 1 gram, and I can do it in a one-step process. Either one is fine when working that problem. All right, let's get that next problem. In this problem, we want to know what is the mass in pounds of 5 moles of gold. So we're starting with the 5 moles. And we have to think it to ourselves. What is it that they want? They want to know the mass. They want to know it in pounds. Where can I go in order to get in the direction of pounds? Well, pounds is a mass, but I can't go from moles to pounds directly. Let's go back to our little map at the beginning and things that we can do. We can go from grams to moles. We can go from moles to grams. Now, if I could get to this grams, then grams is a mass, right? Grams is a mass. If I could get to grams, then I could go on and probably get to pounds, a different mass unit. So let's think about that strategy. I can go from moles to grams, and this is of gold. What's the symbol for gold? That's one of the ones that you need to know for our test. Gold is AU, so I'm going to go from moles of AU to grams of AU. And now once I have grams of AU, there are a few English metric conversions that you need to know. And you need to know how to go from grams to pounds. Okay? And if you will look under the Chapter 1 modules, I have got a document there which is called Things to Memorize. Okay, and you need to memorize all of the gray shaded elements. You need to know their names and their symbols. You need to know the English metric conversions that are listed there. at least for now, you need to know the mass ones, which are the grams to pounds. You need to know the volume ones, which is, let's see, what was that one? It was liters to gallons. And you need to know the length ones, okay? Which was, we have two of them there. We can go between kilograms and miles. And we can, I'm sorry, kilometers, otherwise known as kilometers to miles, or meters to miles, either one. I don't remember which one's on there. One of those is on there. And centimeters to inches is on there, okay? So those are the ones you need to know. You don't need to know the one that has to do with pressure, and you don't need to know the one that's dealing with energy of joules and calories. But you need to know these three. Okay, so that's what you need to know. So we need to know how to go between grams and pounds. So let's do the work. I have 5 moles of gold. And I don't want moles of gold. I'm going to go to grams of gold. So then I go to a periodic table. And I find AU. AU is 196.97. 196.97. Now that always goes with the G, because this is how many grams, by definition, molar mass off the periodic table, is how many grams are in 1 mole. So now I've done that first step. I've gotten to grams. I need to go to the next step. I don't want to stay at grams. So I put grams of gold on the bottom, and I put pounds in the top. And this would be pounds of gold. 1 pound is 453.6 grams. So that was the number that is on that thing to memorize that you've got to know. Now we can take our 5. We can multiply by the value of 196.97, and we can divide by 453.6. This will give me 2.17 pounds. Okay, that's a lot of gold. That's how many pounds of gold it would have in 5 moles. All right, let's go to the next one. How many atoms are in a 12.6 gram sample? So now in this case, we have nickel. We know how many grams we have. Let's back up to that map thing here. We are given the grams. We want to know how many atoms. So we're going to go in this direction. We're going to start with grams. We're going to go to moles. Once we get moles, we're going to go to atoms. So we write down what we're given. 12.6 grams, what it is of nickel. Our first step, and let me just write out the steps, okay? Ah, that's weird. 12.6 grams, and then we're going to go to moles, and then we're going to go to atoms, according to what we saw on our roadmap. Okay, now, cancel the grams, go to moles. Where do we get that number? Get that number at the periodic table. So we look at our periodic table, and we find nickel, and we see that it's 58.69. It goes with the grams, 58.69, because molar mass is how many grams are in 1 mole. Then we go from moles of nickel to atoms. That's our last step. A mole is a whole bunch, 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd. So now we're ready to put that into our calculator. 12.6 divided by 58.69, and then multiply by 6.022. And remember that EE button means times 10 to the 23rd. And I have a value of 1.29 times 10 to the 23rd atoms. There are a lot of atoms of nickel in 12.6 grams. So now we've seen how to go between those three units, grams, moles, and atoms. And I expect you to be able to realize that anytime you want to go between grams and moles, either way you go, you're going to use molar mass, and you go to the periodic table to get that value. The value of molar mass that you get off the periodic table always goes with the G, and a 1 goes with the mole. Then we learn how to go between moles and the actual atom one way or the other. We use Avogadro's number, 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd. And remember, that's how many atoms are in a mole. So that's the way we would use that number.